Thank you for tuning in to Upon the Rock broadcast. I'm your host, Pastor Lawrence Shakir. I believe the Word of God will build a godly foundation in the lives of people. There is more available information on our website. You can log on to shakirministries.org. Now, let's go into today's message. But I come right now, when it comes to this video, to rebuke that spirit, because you will arrive at the location that you're supposed to arrive in, and you will be everything that God calls you to be. Satan, these light afflictions, they're only there to make you stronger. They're only there not only to test you, but to build more stamina, more tenacity inside of you, more faith inside of you, so that you can not only reach your goal, but you can go past that and help somebody else. But too often people get discouraged and they stop the process because they don't want to go through any kind of trouble to get there. They want to just walk down a yellow brick road and make it to Oz without the obstacles that sit in the way. Well, you need these obstacles so that you can appreciate the promise by the time you get there. Okay, I hope I'm talking to somebody here. Look at something else. And when it comes to this closed door, he says, and I'm not going to read all of it, but in Acts chapter 16, verse 6, Paul says, Paul and his companions traveled throughout the region of Pergamum and Galatia, and he says, and having been kept by the Holy Spirit. Now, notice how he says he was kept by the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit closed the door this time. They want to preach in this city, and the Holy Spirit said no. Then they want to go to this city. The Spirit said no. Okay, and he said he was preaching in the province of Asia, and when they came to the borders of Malaysia, they tried to enter into another city, but the Spirit of Jesus, watch this, would not allow them to. Sometimes God will close a door on a situation and keep his hand on the door to make sure that you don't go in there. Why would God do something like that? Somebody says, I thought that's what the devil does. No, God does it too. God will close the door because he knows it's not good for you. And if it's not good for you, it probably may be good for you, but not at this particular time. So he kind of closed the door right now. Have you ever been to like Disney World or been to these theme parks and you try to get there early enough for a ride and it's closed yet until a certain time because they're doing something or somebody else is riding or something like that, but you're in line, but you can't go in yet because it's closed until the proper time, okay? That's what God is doing sometimes where you go through something a little bit too fast, and sometimes you're ahead of schedule, and God kind of just closed the door and says, no, you have to wait a little bit because this opportunity is not ready. You may think you're ready, but you're really not ready yet until the time is appointed. And so that's what happens right here. He says the Holy Spirit stopped us. The Holy Spirit said, no, you're not going to go this far because it's not time yet. It doesn't mean that you're not in the right place. You're in the right place, but it's not the right time yet. And sometimes God has to get you ready, and he has to get other people that's connected to your destiny. He got to get them ready too. And so don't despise that, this door is closed. It's only closed for your benefit because God has your best interest at heart. Okay. So he said the Spirit of Jesus told us not to go. And they went to another city and the Holy Spirit said, no, don't do this. And went to another city. No, don't do it. So they just kind of just sat down for a while and just rested. And then Paul in a dream, if you read through it, he said he had a vision of a God that says, come to Macedonia and help us. So then they woke up and he said, you know what? I concluded that we need to go to Macedonia. All these other places, because as you read, Galatia was one of them. Well, he ended up writing to Galatia. Galatia. Well, you know what I'm trying to say. The people of Galatia, and so he wrote that letter to them. But at that time, he tried to go in and preach, but it wasn't time. So God knew that in the future, that he's going to write to this city. But at this particular time, he had to go to Macedonia. Okay, and so a lot of times we try to beat down a door and say we're here to be here and we're here to do this and we're here to do that, and then God's like, no, you're not. And you can try all you can trying to kick down this door and it's not budging because God says it's not time yet. You're here, but it's not time to go in yet. And so I hope some of you all are trying to see the wisdom behind God when it comes to this, because he knows what's best for you. And sometimes we just have to trust him. And that's where people kind of, it separates those from following God and those who trust God, because people, you know, they don't mind serving God, but a lot of people don't want to wait on God. They don't want to trust God on this. They say, well, Lord, I'm ready, so you need to be ready too. And God doesn't work that way. Whenever he's ready and he knows that you're ready, then that open door will come in. So in the meantime, you need to do like Paul did and just kind of just sit down and listen. Listen what God is saying. Listen to what he's trying to do. And if you don't know how to hear from God, get around people who do hear from God and let them know your plans. You know, of course, you can't tell everybody everything, because some people don't have your best interests at heart. But if you can ever find somebody who loves you for you and is a godly person, and you can share this particular dream with them, then hear what they has to say, because God can be speaking through them for your particular situation and for your own benefit and direction. Okay, and so that's how they got to, you know, Macedonia. And so when God closes the door on you, let him do it. If God's going to close the door, let him do it. Don't decide to break in. You are not a thief. You are not a robber. Don't kick down the door. If the door is closed, don't try to open it. Don't try to force it open. When you have to spend your own energy to make that door open, if you're going to kick down a door, and if you ever do get inside that door, you have to maintain it yourself. See, the first time, if God opens the door, he says, I'll be with you. But if you kick down this door and go in there on your own accord, well, guess what? You have to spend all your energies to make sure that you maintain it. Otherwise, you know, it's just one of those things where you know that you know you should have gotten into. It was a little bit too early. And sometimes I've done that too. You do things a little bit too early. You're in the right track, but you're doing a little some of it a little bit too early. So you have to recognize when God is speaking. I hope I'm talking to somebody. A few notes here. It says, if you decide, like I said, you decide to break down the door and you spend your energy to keep it open. However, when God opens that door for you, then all you got to do is walk through it with ease and assurance. And so that's the thing, is just trust in God. Proverbs chapter 4, verse 26, make level paths for your feet and only take ways that are firm. He said, make level paths for your feet, plan out all your stuff you have, but some of those things in your plan is going to be a little bit shaky, a little bit rocky. That's why he says, only take paths that are firm, something that can hold you up as you continue down this road of life, all right? And so you can't afford to just say, well, this is an open door, I think I'm going to go through it because it looks good. No, you have to wait on God, okay? So the kind of doors that God opens, I'm just going to give you a few things and we're almost done. The kind of doors that God opens in Colossians chapter 4, verse 3. I hope you all are taking notes on this one, because I really spent some time trying to, you know, get this thing together so you all can hear this. Because sometimes you don't just get everything the first time. And so I want you to be able to kind of go back to these scriptures and meditate on this, and so that you can get everything that God is trying to give to you. Okay. Colossians chapter 4, verse 3. And he said, and pray for us too, that God may, watch this, open a door. Pray for us, intercede for us, that God will open a door. It's all right for you to ask God, Lord, open this door for me. But it's also okay to get other people who's part of your destiny, who loves you and can intercede with you. Ask them, pray to God for this door to be open, because if God's going to open it, he's going to open it. If he's not going to open it, he's not going to open it, no matter how many prayers you have. But the prayer of faith moves God, okay? And so, when you have other people agreeing with you, one can chase away 1,000, two can chase away 10,000, but those kinds of prayers kind of move the atmosphere of God, okay? And so, it's okay to ask people to help you pray for a certain, if you're looking for a certain thing, or you're trying to do a certain career move for you and your family. It's all right to ask people to ask God to you know, open this door. There's nothing wrong with that. Okay, people kind of get all bent out of shape, like, no, don't you try to change God's mind. Trust me, you won't not change God's mind, because the Bible says that he's the same yesterday, today, and forever. His methods do change, but God is the same, and he knows the plan from the beginning. So nothing you can do can change God's mind. He relents on certain things, yes, but when it comes to your total destiny, he already knows. And so it's okay. Okay, you can breathe now. It's okay to get people to help you intercede for your particular destiny. He says, and pray for us too, that God may open a door for our message, that we may proclaim it, the mystery of Christ, for which I am in these chains. And so he says, just pray that we continue to do what God calls us to do. I say that prayer often. Most of you all that watch our broadcast, you pray for me, and then I ask you all to pray for this situation and help us to do what God has called us to do, because I know that it's God has placed other Christians and other believers on this earth to ultimately so we can do His will, okay? And so that's what it's all about. And look what He says right here in Acts chapter 14, verse 27. He says, on arriving there, they gathered the church together and reported all that God has done through them and how God had opened the door of faith to the Gentiles. So now these are some of the things that God will do when it comes to your personal life. If you have family members that you've been praying for and they haven't, responded to the gospel all of this time, He says that God will begin to open a door so that message will be received, okay? And so this is something that God does. And so that's why it's so important to not get weary in well-doing, because in due time you will reap if you faint not. And so you have to just stick around long enough to see this promise be fulfilled in your particular life, okay? And so that's another open door, He says. The third one that I got here is in 1 Corinthians chapter 16, verse 9, for a wide door of opportunity for effectual service, watch this, was open to me there, a great promising one, and there were many adversaries. In other words, a wide door was open to us, but with that wide door was many afflictions, many troubles, many other things that most people would say, I don't know if I want to do. They, counting the cost. But if it's a door from God and He says, I will be with you, yes, He'll open that door. Lo, I have prepared a table before you in the presence of your enemies. I have prepared a table. I have opened a door. I prepared a table for you. But look where it's at, in the presence of your enemies. You need to sit down at that table. Yes, they hope you're going to choke. Yes, they hope you're going to die. Yes, they hope that you're going to fall out of your chair. But He says, I prepared a table before you in the presence of your enemies. You're going to have a lot of haters when God starts opening a door for you. But He said that comes with the territory. If you can handle that, you can handle this area that God is trying to take you to. And so that, to me, it's awesome, because God knows me better than I know myself. God knows the struggles that I go through. God knows that, I have a lot of adversaries. He had adversaries. He said, if they hate me, they're going to hate you. And so just realize you're not going to just stroll right into this promise. And I said earlier about the yellow brick road, but even Dorothy and them, they had their degree of trouble just going down the yellow brick road. It was just one path just to go to the Emerald City, and they had to encounter all kinds of, flying monkeys, and they had to have all of the flowers that made them sleepy. They had to go through all kinds of stuff just to get to their destination. And what makes you think that you're going to just walk down this thing without some kind of adversary, some kind of trouble? And so He says, yes, the open door of opportunity was there, but with it was great tribulation and great adversities and a lot of things that happened as a result of this open door. So the question remains, are you going to go through this door and know that God is with you, or are you going to be afraid and let fear kind of just hold you back from what God has called you to do? Because I don't know about you, but I want experience everything that God has called me to do, and I don't want to be afraid to walk through these particular open doors. And I believe I'm talking to some of you right now, is that when God starts to elevate you, which I believe He's going to do, when God starts to put you in front of people of influence, and you start to influence others, a lot of people are not going to like it, and you have to be strong enough to realize that everybody's not going to be your friend. But He says, I've opened a door and I will be with you. If He is with you in this, the key is making sure that He's with you. If He is with you in this, then the Bible says you can run through a troop and you can leap over a wall. So you can do things that are impossible when it comes to regular people. But for you, you'll be able to run through that troop and you'll be able to leap over a wall, because you have God that is with you through this open door. So I hope you enjoyed this broadcast. Share this with somebody who's going through a certain career move or next level about the open doors. But God has an open door for all of you. And I'm just praying for you that you just reach that level and that you don't be intimidated when you walk through that open door, but because he will be with you, okay? So thank you for tuning into this broadcast, and I hope to see you next time. Take care. Bye-bye.
Thank you for listening to Upon the Rock broadcast. If this message has been a blessing, you can help us spread the gospel by sharing this message with your friends. Also, if you're online, please be sure to contact me, either through our website at shakirministries.org or through social media. I would love to hear from you. Together, we can build a godly foundation in the lives of people. Until next time, please know that I'm praying for you, and I hope to see you on our next broadcast.